Welcome to Audio Video System Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you CATV system in this session. CATV means Community Access Television System. And to understand Community Access or Antenna Television System, these are my session outlines. So first, I'll be going to explain basics of CATV. Then after, I'll explain different components which is there with CATV. Then we will see a block diagram which is there with CATV. After that, I'll explain you working of CATV. And then after, we will discuss some advantages and disadvantages which is there with CATV. So CATV is what? CATV is Community Access Television System, or one can say Community Antenna Television System. And in short, this is what cable television system. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of CATV system. See, CATV is also known as cable television. In this type of television system, signals are transmitted through coaxial cable and optical fiber cables. So in CATV systems, you'll be finding optical fiber cable or coaxial cables are connected at different consumers, and consumers are receiving signal by cabling. So dense cabling is there in CATV system, and distribution system that is connected with users. For CATV, it needs to have distribution system. Distribution means there are multiple users, and at different distance we need to have amplification of signal. So in block diagram, I'll explain why there is a need of distribution system in CATV. See, CATV has two different standards. Older one was analog TV, and nowadays newer one, that is digital TV. So previously in cable television, people were having analog television, but nowadays there is digital television which is there with cable TV. Now I'll explain you different components which is there with CATV. So in CATV, there is a huge network of cable, and those cables could be coaxial cable or it may be optical cable. So this is what major component of CATV, and there are nodes from where that signal is connected. So cable operators are having nodes, and those nodes are providing services to different users. So I'll show you how services are provided to different users. For example, here there is a cable operator. Then this cable operator is stretching a cable like this, and on this cable there are different users, those are connected. But as distance will increase, signal will get weak. So cable operator needs to amplify that signal in between somewhere. That is how distribution system is there. Right. So nodes are connected with cable operator, and there is a need of line amplifier as signal is getting weak at longer distance. And see, at different home, cable operator cannot use their power supply as they are providing service. So there is a need of power supply. So power supply, that cable operator will be using it from somewhere, right? And that is what the so essential element which is there with CATV system. And because of this power supply issue, there are some different issues which is generated with CATV system. Power supply is being provided from the battery sometimes, but when you use battery, after some time period that battery will get discharged, and again you will have to provide that power supply by having some other charged battery. So that system is costly by battery. See, there will be head end, and that head end, that is one can say broadcaster, that is connected with distribution hub, and distribution hub is connected with nodes. So those nodes are cable operator, and one can say those nodes are optical nodes. So at cable operator there is optical signal, so that is high quality optical signal which is there at cable operator, and those cable operators are distributing their system via cable, and as distance progresses signal will get weak, so there is a need of amplifier, you can see. So as signal is progressed further there will be amplifier which is regenerating signal and which will be making this signal strong at longer resistance. And in between those cables there are users which is connected and they are receiving service of this CATV. So this is what huge distribution system one can see. So dense cabling is happening, and in this cabling for longer distance signal will get weak, so there is a need of regeneration of signal. So sometimes there can be amplifier, but if signal distortion is more, in that case we need to connect regenerator. So after some distance there will be regenerator, after some distance there will be amplifier, right? So this is how distribution system is there with CATV. Now see, channel television is transmitted by head at particular frequency. So different channels are there at different frequencies, and that one can see in their television even by tuning different channels. So you'll be finding at different frequencies different channels are there. And distribution hub is having amplifier at reasonable distance to keep signal strong. And if you don't provide amplification, in that case you'll be finding distortion is happening in television. So that distortion is happening because of lower strength of signal is received at different user. So all one need to do is they need to provide amplification, and that is what cable operator are doing. Separate television signals do not interfere here with this channel. So you'll be finding separate television signals does not interfere here with this channel. See, cable TV are available at lower cost, and cable TV gives very good service as they are having very limited users to particular operator. If you observe operator strength, then you'll be finding with one operator around 500 to 1000 users are there. So that particular operator can give very good service. When you talk about digital broadcasting system, in that case with broadcaster there are millions of subscriber, or one can say millions of users, so it is extremely difficult to provide service to that many users. But in cable television they are providing very good service, like one can personally communicate. They offer very good packages of programs. So because of competition in the market they give some packages, but when you observe less competition, in that case they can charge as per their wish. But here in metro city you'll be finding so many service providers are available. So in that scenario you'll be finding they are offering very good packages. But in rural areas or in village area you'll be finding very less service providers are there, so in that case they will be charging more. So service cost is cheap even, and cable TV provides good signals in bad weather conditions like heavy rainfall. So see, this is one biggest advantage which is there with cable TV television. Like under bad weather condition even signal strength will be very good as signal is received via cable. While in case of D2H system, you will be receiving signal with wireless technology, where you will be receiving signal from satellite. So under very heavy rainfall, you will be finding because of clouds, signals are not received properly. So cable TV gives very good signals under bad weather condition like heavy rainfall. So these are the advantages which is there with CATV, cable TV. Now there are disadvantages even. Some private company has different cost, right? And video on demand is not available. Internet is not available, as well as gaming is not available in CATV television.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topic which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.